Today's topic name is Introduction to Geology and Branches of Geology to Useful in Civil Engineering. See, Introduction to Geology. What is geology? Geo means earth and the science means study. And so, geo means earth and logy means study. So, geology is the study of earth science. See, Introduction to Geology. Geology in the Greek, geo means earth and logo means science, is a branch of science dealing with the study of earth. What is engineering geology? Application of geological knowledge in the field of civil engineering for execution of safe and stable and economic construction like dam, bridge, and tunnel. What is engineering geology? Better understanding. See, geology in the study of earth. Earth, it means we are studying rock, which type of structure present below the surface, on the surface, what type strength of the rock, and the different properties of rock we are studying in the geology, and which are very useful. All these factors are very useful in engineering geology for the constructive purposes. And so, for the stable and safe construction, we are studying the geology and engineering. Next is the branches of geology useful to civil engineering. See, main branches are physical geology, mineralogy, petrology, structural geology, stratigraphy, paleontology, and economic geology. All are main branches of geology. Physical, mineral, petro, structure, stratigraphy, and allied branches means applied branches which are useful in a civil engineering. Engineering geology, mining geology, geophysics, geohydrology, and geochemistry. See, the next is main branches. See, first is the main branches is physical geology. See, physical geology is what? It is also described as a dynamic geology and geomorphology. It is deal with different physical features on the earth such as mountain, plateau, valley, river, lake, glacier, and volcano in terms of their origin and development. See, what is physical geology? We are studying origin, formation of hills, mountains, plateau, and the river basin and river, many things. How river originate, where it is from, how mountain is originate, shape of the mountain, orientation of mountain, everything we are studying in a physical geology. Mineralogy, this deals with the study of mineral. We know that there are number of minerals present on the earth's surface which have different physical property, and all these minerals are called main constituent of the rock. So identification of mineral, we need to know the physical property and hold these studies, physical properties and their different optical properties, everything studied under the mineralogy. Petrology deals with study of rock. We know that earth's surface, the number of on earth's surface there are three types of rock present: igneous, sedimentary, and metamorphic. All these rocks have the different property and different applications. So all these studies, all these factors are studied in the petrology. The next point is a structural geology. What is structural geology? Like different geological morphological structure present on the earth's surface, like valley, river, plateau, or these are all a geomorphological structure, but they are different structures like a fold, similar wave like pattern structure called as fold, and this is called as fault. Similar structure present on the earth's surface, and how its fold form, how its fault form, what is the different conditions are present with this formation, and because of this fold and fault, what will be the happen, and how it act during the construction. Everything we are studying in the structural geology. Then next is stratigraphy. What stratigraphy? We know that the earth is a sphere and made up of different zones, but only crust made up of they all three types of rocks. So rocks are arranged in the form of layer, one by one above, one by one. So which rock is formed first and which rock is formed later on, which composition is present, and age of the formations, everything we are studying in the stratigraphy. And this is called as history of the earth. Study of the earth is a history. The sedimentary rock is called as historical geology. It is also called as stratigraphy. See, again, physical geology, study of geomorphology, mineralogy, study of mineral, petrology, in which we are studying a study of rock, structural geology, in which we are studying a different structures, geological structure, fold, fault, join, and unconformity, And then stratigraphy, study of the history of the earth. Then these are the main branches. Then next is a another main branches is a paleontology and economic geology. What is paleontology? Study of fossil. Fossil means what? During the formation of the sedimentary rocks, how sedimentary rock form? Because of number of sediment deposit in the form of layer, and it get compact and form a sedimentary rock. But during this formation, number of parts of plant and animal buried under the sediment or remain as it is. And this is called as fossil. And how is this formed? Which type of rock is present? Which type of fossil belong to which type of animals? Which type of part of the plant? Everything we are studying in the paleontology. It is a branch dealing with the life of past geological period. Is known as known from fossil remains. Economical geology. Economical geology is the study of earth material that can be used for economic and industrial purposes, like zinc, galena. These are the economic minerals, and their study, their properties, their importance, where it is formed, for this excavation of this all these material, which type of mining is required. Everything we are studying in economic geology. Then next is allied branches, which we can call it applied branches, which are engineering geology, mining geology, geophysics, geohydrology, and geochemistry. See engineering geology. Engineering geology deals with the application of geological knowledge in the field of civil engineering for excavation, safe, stable economic construction like dam, bridge, and tunnel. See, we have seen the definitions. You understand properly what this is. The river basin, and we want to construct the bridge on it. Just we have to know whatever the formation present below this river basin. See, if it is igneous rock present, and from this position and above this, it is sedimentary rock present. So, for during the construction of bridge, we have to know this is which site. We have to know the whatever the which kind of rock is present below the basin. Why? Because sedimentary rock is very soft compared to the igneous rock. For stable and the proper construction, we have to make any construction on or in through the hard rock. See, for fire of the bridge must be reach up to this igneous rock. Not it does not place up to the only sedimentary rock. So if fire of the bridge reaches up to the igneous rock, so whatever the material passes on the bridge, all this load are passed into this igneous rock, and igneous rock can sustain that much load, and bridge can be stable. If you place it is up to only in the sedimentary rock is soft, doesn't sustain that much load, so bridge will be collapsed. So for stable and good construction, we have to know which kind of the pressure, which kind of structure present below. So engineering geology, so geological knowledge is what state which kind of rock is there and their property, all are geological knowledge. And construction is engineering. So in the whole study, we are studying in a one subject like construction based on the which kind of geological structure or geological condition. So this is the engineering geology. The next is a mining geology. It deals with the application of geological knowledge in the field of mining. Why we want to excavate the mine at particular position? So we are going to excavate this mine. For mine excavation, for what purpose? For excavation of mineral. So which mineral is important? So excavation cost and the mineral cost, and for identification of mineral, everything we are studying in the mining geology. What is geophysics? The study of physical property like density, magnetism of the earth of its part. Like we know that earth is in sphere shape, but it contains different magnetite minerals. Earth has a gravitational field also, and earth contains water also. So different properties we are going to be studying in a geophysics, like electrical resistive property, magnetism, and gravitational property. Everything we are studying in a geophysics. Geohydrology, they may also be called as hydrogeology. It deals with the occurrence, movement, and nature of the groundwater in area. What is geohydrology? We know that earth consists water. So water accumulated at particular position between these two rock, or between these two kind of formation, between two rock, is called as aquifer. Water accumulation at particular position called as aquifer. So we have to study where is aquifer present, and where we can drill the well, when we will get the more amount of water from up to 12 months or up to 1 year or more than that year. everything we are studying in geohydrology. Then geochemistry. This is a branch, is a relatively more recent and deals with the occurrence, distribution, abundance, mobility, different element in the earth's crust. Then geochemistry deal with the chemistry, different economically or different elements like silica, and they are different elements which are present in the earth crust, and the study of this element called geochemistry. Geology is important in all three aspects of each construction: planning, design, and construction. See, if you have one project construction of tunnel, and you have to pass this tunnel into this particular hill, so you cannot go directly and drill and pass the tunnel. For this, we have to do one thing is planning. What to do is must is planning. Then you must be think about design, and then have to do is construction. So what is the planning? For this planning, we have to know which kind of rock is present here. So which kind of rock is present? This hill or hill made up of which type of rock? So see, for this we have to drill here and find out which material is present. After finding out, mark it. It is a below surface present up to the sedimentary rock. It is here is metamorphic rock, and above is igneous, and some water table or perch kind of means smaller water table is present here. So you can see sedimentary, meta, and igneous rock. So find out the strength of this all this rock. After finding out, we get the information like this: the sedimentary rock is very soft, and metamorphic rock is very hard, and the again here is metamorphic rock, here is sedimentary rock, and sedimentary rock is very soft, and again below is metamorphic, above metamorphic, and more metamorphic is igneous rock, and its water table is present. So I will get the information, so I get the information of the whole hill structure. So now I'm going to do the planning. What is the planning? Tunnel will be passed through the soft rock, doesn't pass through the hard rock. So tunnel I'm going to pass into this soft rock and excavate this whole rock, doesn't remain, and after the excavation make lining around this tunnel, so remaining sedimentary rock doesn't get fall. And above the tunnel is hard rock, and below the tunnel is very hard rock. So after passing any vehicle through this tunnel or any object, that load can be sustained by this hard rock, so tunnel will be safe. If I made the tunnel into whole excavation metamorphic rock, so and below present the tunnel is sedimentary rock, so it cannot be sustained the very high load. So tunnel will be not remain more or so tunnel will be not more durable, and it going to be collapse after some days or not only the collapse, but either problem will be appear. So geology is more important while planning, design, and the construction. See, this is the example of the tunnel. I can give another one example for the different construction, like consider the we have to excavate the bridge, we have to construct the bridge. So we know the whatever the material present below this river basin, because bridge will be construction across the bridge, across the river basin. So this is the bridge, and this is the piers of the bridge. So piers must be reached for up to hard rock. So that up to hard rock, because by overlying whatever the pass object will produce force or load that can be sustained by the bridge. For this sustainability, we have to fire reaches up to the hard rock. So for this, we have to know which type of rock is present below the surface. So geology here also too important for planning, for designing, and for the construction too. Then next is the planning. What is the planning? Following geological information is greatly useful in planning and engineering project. So for planning, we have to know which type of rock is present below, what is exactly situation, and for this finding out which type of rock and what are the situation, we use for this type of map, topographical map give the information of the total land area, hydrological map give the information of this land or the surface where is water is get accumulated, and geological map represent which type of rock is present at particular area. So design of the project depend upon the following factor: extension of the hard bed and their depth from the inclination. Design of project depend upon the following factor: the existing hard bed rock and their depth from an inclination, the mechanical property along and across the site of the proposed project, present nature and distribution pattern of planes of the structural weakness, the position of groundwater table in locality, seismic character of the area from the seismic history, and prediction and future seismicity. So design the project depend following factor. First factor is which type of rock. See, I already told you that tunnel can pass into the sedimentary rock or above below surface space must be hard rock. The existing hard bed rock and their depth, according to that where will be tunnel located, we can, and according to that we can design. And then mechanical property. Kind of property, it means what hardness and how it can be sustained load or not, and the plane of weakness means if it is fracture, fold, fall, if it is present in that rock, so we can according to based on that fold and fall we can use a different design for the construction. And the position of groundwater table, see already I told you the example in which basically below sedimentary above metan, another one is water table is here. If water table present in this metamorphic rock or we excavate, then that time we have to remove all this water is present here. So according to that, or either we cannot construct the tunnel here. If it is water table is large, we can construct the tunnel in different places. So based on the position condition, we change the design. And seismic characters means which area. Constructed site present in each zone of the seismicity, first, second, third zone. On the basis also we can change the design or we make the earthquake resistant structure. In construction, knowledge of geological history of the area of great importance for construction in a geological sensitive area as those of coastal belt, seismic zone and performance region. Construction of underground project like tunnel cannot be undertaken without the knowledge of geological character, setting of the rock and their relevance to the load imposed. Obviously construction should be based on the which geological condition, on the basis of we can conclude it, which type of design we are going to reach, where we can construct and how it is to proceed for the different climates or different natural disaster. So everything is depend upon the geological construction condition. Then geology and water resource development. The water resource engineering has to understand the water cycle in detail. Study of water cycle is an essential for effective planning extension of major water resource development program on national and regional level. Geology in town and regional planning. Land utilization is a based and aesthetic in a manner. Planning must be in tune with the natural features and the process of region. Before ending with this slide, just understand properly how geology is more important. See, I'm giving you another one example. One example is if you want to construct the dam at particular site. Dam at particular site, that time you have to know the geological condition of that bed. So if you want to construct a dam, see which is the geological condition is here. See, it is also all our horizontal beds and different consist different type of rock, and below this bed it very hard and compact rock, along is all very compact and below is very soft rock. Doesn't matter if below is very soft rock. At first two stages, if it is very hard rock, then you can construct easily dam here. So lower impose of dam from below the surface and it easily can be sustained. If it is these below the surface at that it consists fault like structure, or if fault is very active, then we cannot construct dam on that particular site. If it is any fault like structure is present below that particular surface, then we have to construct the fault above on these structures. We can above on at this particular place, but here we cannot construct dam. Here also we construct the dam, but here we cannot construct, here we cannot construct the dam. So on the basis of the size, we can choose where the location of the construction. Similarly, consider about the tunnel. This is the example of dam. Similarly, consider about tunnel. If it is cold present below the surface and it's very hard compact rock, but we can tunnel can pass only the crease part. We cannot pass the tunnel to the trap part. The tunnel safe into the only through the crease part of the fold. It doesn't safe under this condition of doesn't safe under in a trap part. So on the basis of which geological condition present below, we can change design and the location of the construction according to that. So it is very important for construction which kind of geological situation present and that best perfectly construction at that construction site. Thank you.